and Gampis, senior artists, friends of NDM in Mumbai. The National Gallery of Modern Art, Mumbai, Ministry of Culture, Government of India, is pleased to announce a retrospective of the senior artist, Sri Pramod Babu Ramteke. Its name is Open Mind, a retrospective of Pramod S. Ramteke. It is indeed a rare privilege for the NDME Mumbai to have such a beautiful gathering here today. I would like to invite our Director General, Sri Advaita Chayan Gandayak, sir, Srimati Anita Rupa Vaktaram, Director NDME Mumbai, the artist, Sri Pramod Babu Ramteke ji, our guest of honor, Dr. Sarir Dhofi, eminent art historian and art scholar, and former director of NDME Mumbai, Sri Vilas Sinde, chairperson, advisory committee of NDME Mumbai, and Sri Shavi Savarkar, senior artist, to come on the stage for lighting the lamp and to formally inaugurate the show. Thank you. To invite Director Madam to present her awards to Dr. Sarir Dhofi Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Now I'd like to invite Shanta sir to present her awards to Diji sir. Thank you. Now I would like to invite Director NG in the Mumbai for welcome address.
Respected Pramod Babu Ramteke ji, the artist whom we all gathered here to celebrate and whose work we are here to appreciate. Shri Abhay Charan Karnaik, Director General, National Gallery of Modern Art. Dr. Saryu Doshi, eminent scholar and art historian. And Shri Stavan Savarkar ji, also a close associate of the artist that we've gathered here to celebrate. And last but not the least, Shri Vilas Shinde, the chairperson of the advisory committee of Mumbai, who's been a pillar of strength. So we welcome all of them, and I am indeed extremely happy to find a very healthy gathering here, and despite the COVID pandemic, and in fact it almost seems like the old days, but with some difference. So it's been almost 1.5 years since we probably gathered here to open a show, and a lot has changed both in our lives and probably in the gallery too, and regulars would have noticed. If I can just dwell a little on what all has changed, you would have seen, many of you would be habituated to see that semicircle which is now not there. So unfortunately there was a lot of termite infestation and we had to remove that. So the entire look of the ground floor has changed. And since nothing much was happening within the gallery, we've tried to focus on the infrastructure front. So we have two LED screens which we've tried to make interactive. We've done the LED lighting of the gallery. We've also tried to do the super jet cleaning of the exterior walls of the gallery. And we've roped in the CPWD horticulture wing to help make our gallery greener. So these are the efforts that we've been trying to focus on, because art as such had taken a setback somewhat. But then, now that we've gathered courage and a majority of us are vaccinated, I think life is limping back to normal. And here we are to celebrate the artist Shri Ramteke, who comes from Nagpur, that part of Maharashtra which perhaps has not been shown so much. And so this is an excellent opportunity for us to learn about regional art, and with a completely different Varhadi flavor, if I may say so. So, those of you who already walked through the show would have noticed how there have been so many twists and turns in the way he's practiced, starting off from portraiture. You have Baba Saab's portrait there, beckoning you as though, and then right up to the dome, which is like the icing on the cake as always. So I would request all of you to see the entire show, and we save the best for the last, and you can take my word for that. So, and I would also take this occasion to welcome all those new employees who've joined NGLA Mumbai, and some who've also returned. So we have Mr. Dhongri, who has come back from NGLA Delhi. We also have Mr. Virendra Bhargav, publication assistant, who's joined us. And we have four new staff, multitasking staff. I extend a hearty welcome to all of you. And let me also finish my speech in Hindi. जैसा कि आप सब जानते हैं, हम हिंदी पखवाड़ा मना रहे हैं, और ये एक सुनहरा अवसर है कि हम अपने इस राजभाषा को याद करें, उसका उपयोग करें. और हमारी यही कोशिश रहती है कि जितने भी हम लेख लिखे या बैनर बनाए या इनवाइट भी बनाए, उसे द्विभाषी करें, जिससे कि आप लोगों के बीच हिंदी का जो है प्रयोग और प्रचार प्रसार हो सके. तो इसी के साथ मैं विदा लेती हूँ, और आपसे अनुरोध है कि पूरा शो जरूर देखिएगा और मजा जरूर लीजिएगा. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू मैम. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट डायरेक्टर जनरल सर टू एड्रेस द ऑडियंस.
सबको प्रणाम. सरयू जोशी जी, रामटेक जी, सभी सावरकर जी, विलास जी, अनिता जी स्टेज पे हैं, और हमारा एडवाइजरी कमेटी पूरा, तुका जी, सालवे जी, जो सब लोग आए हैं, वहाँ मंजर जी भी कोने में बैठे. तो काफी ऐसे एक्चुअली डेढ़ साल दो साल का बाद ऐसे डेढ़ साल हो गया तो हम कभी मिले नहीं थे, और पहली बार मिले ये सबसे बड़ी बात है। सुबह से हमसे बात कर रहे हैं, मिल रहे हैं। एक्चुअली आर्टिस्ट ऐसा ना, वो बताते हैं ना, फिजिकल सोशल डिस्टेंस बनाना बहुत मुश्किल होता है, क्योंकि फिजिकल डिस्टेंस होता है, हो सकता है, लेकिन सोशल डिस्टेंस नहीं हो सकता, क्योंकि हम तो वही है जिसको जोड़ने वाले हैं, तो हमेशा हम सबको जोड़ते हैं। तो आज प्रामटेक जी उनका काम, सुबह से उनसे भी बात कर रहा था कि किस तरीका वो काम किए, वो जो बचपन में उनको याद आया था कि दीवार में कैसे काम वो करते थे। और कभी कभी ऐसे भी हम लगता है ना, वो 7-8 साल जो बचपना होता है ना, उस टाइम सारी कंप्लीट हो जाता है, बाद में सारी रिपीट होता है। तो अभी भी मेरे को बता रहे थे कि दीवार में मैं कैसे ड्राइंग कर रहा था, उसका आखिर में अभी भी उनका जो काम देखेंगे कि वो लाइन है, और हमारी जो मिनिएचर पेंटिंग भी देखेंगे वो लाइन से ही शुरू होता है। और ऐसे उनका काम मैं ऊपर से नीचे तक देखा है सारी। एक इस तरह का फैमिली से आया कि जहाँ वो नेवल वाला जो स्ट्रांग होता है, वो खुद भी ब्लैक बेल्ट है, और इस तरह का म्यूजिक में काफ़ी रुचि उनका, और उनका साधना पेंटिंग में, स्कल्पचर में, स्कल्पचर मेटेरियल को, मेटेरियल के साथ इतना दोस्ती है मैंने देखा। वो पत्थर के बारे में भी बता रहे थे कि वो पत्थर ऐसे ही रखे, लेकिन जैसे कि आपका शरीर में प्यार हो जाता है ना थोड़ा, हाँ टाटू लगाते हैं, कुछ करते हैं, वो पत्थर का ऊपर 2-4 ड्रिल किए टाटू जैसा है। तो एक मेटेरियल का साथ किस तरह का प्यार है उनका, पेंटिंग और स्कल्पचर देखने से ही पता चलता है। और एक 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 सोच ऐसा है कि वो शुरू में बहुत पोर्ट्रेट में काम किए, उनका अम्बेडकर जी का पोर्ट्रेट सुबह हम देख रहे थे तो इतना सुंदर, और वो कलर और जो लाइन उनका, वो फॉर्म का बारे में जो बात करते थे कि कैसे शुरू शुरू में वो इस तरह का काम करते थे, अभी यहाँ तक पहुँच गए, मतलब जहाँ से शुरू किए थे वहाँ पहुँच गए। तो एक एक उनको लगता है कि एक आर्टिस्ट का जो पूरा लाइफ है आप इसमें देख सकते, सबसे बड़ी बात है कि फील कर सकते, जब आप फील करते हैं ना, और हर चीज़ बोलना नहीं पड़ता है। तो इसे मेरा घर में मेरा ग्रैंड मदर, मैं जब कहाँ भी घूम के आ जाता हूँ, वो पाँव से सिर तक पहले छू लगी, उससे उसको पता हो रहा था मैंने गलत किया कि अच्छा किया। वो जो सिक्स सेंस है ना, बहुत जरूरी है। अभी सोसाइटी से ये सारी खत्म हो रहे हैं। अब मैं पूरा इतिहास लेके बताऊँ ना घर पे, वो किसी को समझ में नहीं आता। जब आप फील नहीं करते ना, फिर कुछ भी करिए वो, जैसे पत्थर पे भी हम काम करते हैं, वो पत्थर को टच करने से ना एक वाइब्रेशन होता है, वो शुरू में झगड़ा होता है, फिर कॉम्प्रोमाइज होता है, एक स्टेज ऐसा आता है कि आपका स्किन और स्टोन का स्किन दोनों मर्ज हो जाते हैं, फिर दोस्ती शुरू होता है। फिर अब दोस्ती अगर हो जाता है ना, उनका सब चीज अच्छा लगता है। इसलिए मेरे को बता रहे थे जो पत्थर उठा के लाए थे वो कहाँ से ऐसे रखे हैं, थोड़ा सा उठाना भी मुश्किल है पत्थर, तो उठा के ऐसे हाथ से गिर लिया तो वहां से एक फॉर्म निकाला, वो ऐसे रखे हैं, आप देखेंगे उसको, तो कितना प्यार है। जो प्यार होता है ना, अगर मेटेरियल का साथ दोस्ती हो गया ना, फिर तो आपको हर चीज उसका अच्छा लगेगा। तो इस तरह का व्यक्ति आज उनका शो यहाँ पर हम कर रहे हैं, और एनजीएम पूरा टीम इसमें लगे, और जो क्यूरेटर हैं उनका नाम मैंने एक्चुअली भूल गया, जो क्यूरेटर जब में हेल्प किया एनजीएम को पूरा, नाम तो बताइए ना, प्रभाकर जी, उनसे भी सुबह हम बात कर रहे थे, बहुत यंग है, वो एनर्जेटिक है, और हर चीज को मेरे को भी बता रहे थे कैसे उनका साथ में काम किए, कैसे शुरू में किस तरह का, फिर ज़्यादातर बात उनसे भी मैंने बात डिस्कस से मिला है। तो एक आर्टिस्ट और दोनों मिलके जब डायलॉग होता है, वो एक्चुअली उसी टाइम आप लोग भी उनसे भी कभी बातचीत करेंगे, वही चीज़ मैं जो बात बता रहा हूँ वो चीज़ आप फील कर सकते। तो आप लोग सब आए कोरोना का टाइम, और हम लोग मिले हैं, और ऐसे हम रेगुलर बिल एक्चुअली अभी लगातार हम प्लान कर रहे हैं। अभी हमारा एनजीएम को सिल्वर जुबली हो रहे 25 साल, आप सोचिए 25 साल बहुत बड़ी बात है। और उसमें हम चाहते हैं कि बड़ा सा कुछ अच्छी तरह से अनिता जी को आज भी हम बता रहे थे कि 25 साल हो रहे हैं तो कुछ तो सोचना चाहिए भाई, 25 साल लाइफ का बहुत बड़ा टाइम होता है, तो सिल्वर जुबली हम कैसे बनाएं। और हमारे जो देश बना रहे हैं जिसको अमृत महोत्सव 75 ईयर्स हो गया, तो उसके लिए हम क्या कर सकते हैं, आर्टिस्ट कम्युनिटी कैसे काम करे, क्या करे, तो उसके लिए भी हम आज चर्चा किए। तो आप लोग से मैं शेयर कर रहा हूँ कि ये एनजीएम 25 साल हो गया, तो आपका कंट्रीब्यूशन जो आपको अच्छा लगता है आप बता सकते हैं और उसको हम आगे लेंगे। और आज सबको धन्यवाद, स्पेशल रामटेक जी जो उनका फैमिली से अभी बता रहे थे बच्चे भी बाहर हैं, और मतलब इस तरह का स्टेज कोरोना टाइम में इतना बड़ा सारी काम इकट्ठी करना और यहाँ पर लाके शो तैयार करना इतना इजी बात नहीं, स्पेशल कोरोना टाइम में जो हम बात करते हैं वो सारी मैंने देखा है कि वो मेरे को बताए खुद खड़े होके सारी चीज इसी उम्र में खुद खड़े होके वो वहाँ डिस्प्ले कर रहे थे। तो स्पेशल धन्यवाद देता हूँ रामटेक जी, पूरा टाइम दे के शो को तैयार किए, और सबको धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
Thank you, sir. I would like to invite our director of honor, Dr. Sarir Doshi, to come and stay and address the audience. It is indeed most gracious of Shri Garnayak Ji, DG NGMA, and Srimati Anita Rupa Vataram, Director NGMA, to invite me as the guest of honor this evening. I wish to thank them and to express my deep appreciation to them. This evening we have all gathered to celebrate Shri Ramtek's exhibition titled Open Mind, a retrospective of his works executed over 55 years. The exhibition traces his works in three phases: his early years, the transit stage through which he passed, and then his later years. His last years were a stage where he experimented a lot. He experimented with mediums, he experimented with compositions, he experimented with forms, and was attracted to abstract minimalism. So his trajectory has been going over various stages and through various phases and through various stylistic expressions. We find that he is a person who has an open mind. I'm not surprised that he decided to call his exhibition an open mind, because he was a person who was always open to ideas. Ideas of his friends and contemporaries, ideas that were expressed by his teachers, and also by studying international artists, he began to shape his vision and his stylistic expression. Now this is a person who is ready to take, who is ready to imbibe, to get inspired and to explore various phases and various mediums, various expressions to define his own. And today we will see all this sort of phases, the trajectories, the transitions, the way in which he proceeded through that. This is truly an educational experience for all of us, because we have to see how an artist progresses. And retrospectives are a great contribution towards that study. I wish to
also say that having his exhibition here is a very fitting tribute to his work, because this particular space has been a crucible of intellectual and academic activities. This hall, which we all see today, has been reshaped and renovated. Earlier, it was a concert hall, and it was a hall that was built during, it was conceived in 1910 by the government of Bombay, and it was endowed by Sir C.J. Kavasji Jahangir, and the idea was to situate it at a place where it would have easy access, people would have easy access. So they decided that the two wings of the Institute of Science, which are like brackets, why not take the space in the center, a rotunda, which would serve as a connecting link, also give it a certain prominence. So the architect, Mr. Wittet, was asked to come and to design this. Now, he was a person who was very interested in Indian forms, in how the Indian architecture had shaped itself over the centuries. He was most inspired by the dome of the Gulbarga Mosque. He also looked at certain Mughal architecture. But for this hall, he decided that I'm going to use the neoclassical idiom of European art, because, he said, science is something that is more aligned to the West, whereas forms and all you can see in the East. So the entire scheme of the Science Institute, including this building, was designed in the European neoclassical form. The hall got ready in 1914. That was the time the First World War was declared, and the science wings were used for keeping, it was used as a hospital, as was the Prince of Wales Museum. But the hall remained open, and many lectures and many activities took place here. There were shows of artists, there were concerts and things like that. But because it was a hall meant for the Science Institute, that got precedence over everything else. So lectures were held here, examinations were held here, but otherwise there were cultural activities. There was Indian classical music, Kesar Bhai Kherkar sang here, Alag here, performed here, Vilayat Khan performed here. So there were all these Indian artists who were performing here. They loved the space. The only problem was acoustics. They tried to correct the acoustics by putting cloth everywhere to absorb the sound, but it was not enough. Anyway, it was such a good hall that people came here, that people enjoyed it. And there were also Western music that was held here. Mehndi Mehta, Zubin Mehta's father, performed here. Then certain associations like the Bombay Madrigal Association, the Paranjyoti Orchestra, all these people came here and they performed here. So this was a cultural hub, you know, so to say, and an academic and intellectual hub. Because it was also a place where a number of freedom fighters spoke. It was a public hall where people would come and they would give speeches. And Mahatma Gandhi gave his first speech here after coming from Africa. So this has a certain vibration to this hall. And it was something that everyone, you know, a place where everyone enjoyed coming. But with time, it began to deteriorate. And its decline started. And acoustics were very dissatisfactory. The hall, the seats were not good. The upkeep was not good. So aste aste, so to say, other halls that had come up in the meanwhile with air conditioning and good acoustics began to draw people away from here, with the result that this decline became very evident. There were boxing matches held here, an ice rink was put in here, and all sorts of shows, craft shows, and not of the highest quality, but ordinary shows were taking place. This development made most of the artists very unhappy. People like Jahangir Sabhawala, people like Tayyab Mehta, Akbar Badamsi, then Kinku Gandhi particularly, they felt that the hall was going to deteriorate. So they all started saying that why can't we have a museum of modern art in this hall? A museum or a gallery would be the right thing to have. So each one tried it in his own way to influence the thinking of the government. Jahangir Sabhawala talked to C.J. Kavasti Jahangir because he was his cousin and he persuaded him. He said, you have donated this hall, why don't you change the sort of pro forma that you gave them, that make it also, it can be changed into a museum. Keiko Gandhi spoke to Popul Jaikar, and through her, he influenced Indira Gandhi to propose a project where this hall could become the Museum of Modern Art. Of course, all this took years, a lot of work went into it, but finally it was approved, and it was, the work on it started. But it started very slowly with lots of disruptions and all, with the result that for many years, 5-7 years, nothing really transpired. Then Mr. V.K. Deshmukh, who was the cabinet secretary in Delhi, came to Bombay after his retirement, and he was asked to take this project on. Now he was a person who was interested in getting things done. And wherever he felt that things, obstructions were coming up, he tried to solve it. And that helped because then this process of constructing this started moving. At the same time, there were people like Ram Pradhan and all who were helping us. And before long, this particular place became ready in 1996. And in December 1996, the hall was opened. In the first few years, we were very fortunate because it was a year of Indian, 50th year of Indian independence, and a lot of people from abroad also wanted to hold exhibitions here. We had the Enduring Image by the British Museum and a number of activities, and it inspired people so much that there were lines outside. Then we had, later on, 2-3 years later, we had the Picasso exhibition. So, you know, we were able to bring so many things here, and we were able to have related events to make it an interesting thing. And so this became a prized possession. And today we see how beautifully the exhibitions are mounted. The first exhibition that DG mounted, I remember he put up these bamboos and he hung paintings in there. It was very innovative. You know, this place is a place where innovation can be used, can be thought of, can be created, and it gives you wonderful results. An exhibition that I saw of Mr. Gadnayak in Delhi, he had used it as pedestals, packing cases. Now again, a very interesting idea. You know, these are things we learn from people like him and people who have otherwise curated exhibitions here. We have Bhupen Khakkar's exhibition here. We have had Lakshman Shrestha, Jahangir Nicholson's collection shown here. So this place has become a prized asset for Bombay. And because it is a prized asset, it is very important that we all celebrate it. We enjoy it. We will celebrate its 25th year and be happy that Bombay has a wonderful place like this. Thank you all you artists who have come here, many of you might know. And I respect and I hope that we will meet again soon. Thank you. And thank you, Anita, and thank you, Dr. Okay.
Now I would like to invite Sri Pramod Ramtekeji to share his experience and artistic journey with us. Pramod Babu Ramtekeji is a prominent abstract artist who has portrayed as a static point of your. He navigated through various art forms to create figurative works, sculptures, graphics, conceptual propositions, and abstractions which allude to his beliefs.
लगता है हम बताएं कि यहीं पर बात करना है नहीं मैं स्टेज पे जाके बात करूं
Ajay Dias, 1 year, Ganaik Ji, 1 year, Shri Doshi Ji, 1 year, Director Bhautaran Ji, Vilas Shinde, JJ के हमारे विद्यार्थी, सिलेक्शन कमेटी के चेयरमैन और मेरे दोस्त सभी सावरकर मेरे पर बोलने आ गए, क्या बोलेंगे पता नहीं मुझे। और साथ में ही ऑडियंस पर बैठे मेरे कई दोस्त है, आर्टिस्ट आए हुए हैं, हर एक का नाम लेना कुछ मुमकिन नहीं है। सबको मेरा सलाम, गुड इवनिंग। मेरा भाई भी आया है, विकास बहू भी है। तो सभी लोग बड़े प्यार से आए हुए हैं। हमें मुझे इस समय एक शेर याद आया हुआ है सर, तो शेर बड़ा गहरा है, मालूम नहीं किसने लिखा। शायर कहता है, उसके बारे में कहता है, हर कलाकार के बारे में कहता है, हर स्कॉलर के बारे में कहता है, हर आदमी जो क्रिएटिव है या जो भी ऐसा ऐसा है जिसको भी वो मोटिवेट करता है अपने शेर में, वो कहता है अपने बारे में, लेकिन हम सबको वो लागू होता है। वो कहता है कि अभी से देखो ना, अभी से देखो ना मंजिल के ख्वाब ऐ दानिश। शायर का नाम है दानिश। अभी से देखो ना मंजिल के ख्वाब ऐ दानिश, अभी तो सैकड़ों पत्थर तुम्हारी राह में है। मेरी राह में भी काफी पत्थर है, रहेंगे उसको पार कर जाने का है, हम सबको जाने का है। और हम सभी जा रहे हैं अपने अपने ढंग से, अपने अपने कला से, अपने अपने ज्ञान से, विज्ञान से। कोई इंजीनियर है, कोई डॉक्टर है, वो भी एक कलाकार है, उसमें भी कला बसी हुई है। तो किस तरह से वो कला बाहर लाता है और ये अपने भारतवर्ष को भारत बना ऊंचा करता है, उसके लिए ये शेर है कि पत्थर है वो तो कभी कम नहीं हो गए, उसे पार कर जाने का। ये हम सोचे कि ये हो गया मेरा तो वहीं स्टॉप हो जाता है, इसलिए इस शायर को भी मेरा सलाम है जो इतनी अच्छी शायरी करता है। शायर लोग, कवि लोग, साहित्यिक हमारी आंखें खोल देते हैं, हमारे रास्ते खोल देते हैं, हमें रास्ता बताते हैं, उस रास्ते पर चलना नहीं चलना यह हर एक को सोचने की बात है, लेकिन चलना चाहिए। बड़े बड़े संतों ने कहा है कि चलना चाहिए, रास्ता बताया है दुनिया को बताया है। तो ये कला का भी मकसद यही है कि प्यार बांटे, जो हो सके तो बांटिए अपनी मसरतें, अपनी खुशियां, मसरतें यानी खुशियां, जो हो सके तो बांटिए अपनी मसरतें। ये सोचना गलत, ये सोचना गलत कि जमाने से क्या मिला, जमाने से क्या मिला, ये हमें नहीं सोचना चाहिए, हमें अपना काम करते रहना चाहिए। अभी हमारे आदरणीय गन्नायक जी ने कहा है कि ये बचपने का जो था एक खेल था, वो खेल कैसा क्या बदल गया, उसमें कैसी तब्दीली आ गई। काम करते करते एक मैंने ये जो एक रास्ता चुना है, पहले रास्ता भटक गया था, लेकिन बाद में वो रास्ते पर मैं खुद आ गया। तो वो जो रास्ता था पहले का, जो ये खेल था कि जहां भी दीवार मिली बचपन का 6-7 साल का, वहां जो भी है अभी उन्होंने काम मुझे वो याद आ गया। अभी वो कोयले से दीवार को कैसी भी टेढ़ी मेढ़ी लकीरें जो मारता था, वो रखी रही थी, वो एक खेल था, लेकिन उसमें एक इमोशंस थे, मालूम नहीं कि वो इमोशंस थे क्या नहीं ये मुझे पता नहीं, लेकिन वो कुछ तो भी था, कुछ तो भी अंदर की एनर्जी थी। अब जो इसके स्टडी किया, वो चाहे बिजनेस बोलो चाहे लाइक बोलो जो कुछ भी बोलो, जब मैं एजुकेशन लेना इधर शुरू किया कॉलेज में आया, तब वो जो खेल था जो चाइल्डलेस थी वो प्रेयर में बदल गया। वो जो महाविद्यालय में जब आया तो वो जो खेल नहीं रहा वो एक इबादत हो गई, और इबादत ही जो है वो रंग लाई है। हम सभी इबादत करने वाले लोग हैं, सब आए हुए यहाँ मौजूद जो है, बड़े बड़े स्कॉलर है, शरीफ दोषी जी है जिनको पहली बार मैं देख रहा हूँ, जिनका पहली बार मैं मेरे बारे में कहना सुन रहा हूँ, रूपावतरण जी है, अपने विलास शिंदे जी है, काफी ये टीम ने काफी, अब कितना शुक्रिया अदा करे कुछ समझ में नहीं आता। मेरे दोस्त है उधर बैठे हुए रवि मंडली, बहुत सारे है, अनिल नाइक बैठा हुआ है, और बहुत सारे विद्यार्थी है, बहुत सारे दोस्त है उधर बैठे हुए। तो ये सबका हमारी जिंदगी में बहुत सारे लोगों का एक ऐसा हेल्प रहता है जो हमें साथ देते हैं। कभी कभी क्या होता है कि हम चलते हैं, बड़ी ठोकरें लग जाती है, ठोकरें खाते हैं, खून निकलता है, हम गिर जाते हैं, फिर भी गिरते हुए पड़ते हुए हमें हमारा मकसद नहीं छोड़ना चाहिए। जो रास्ता आपने अपनाया है वो रास्ता अपनाइए, भारत का नाम ऊंचा कीजिए, ये कहता हूं। धन्यवाद।
आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट श्री विलास सर टू शेयर हिज एक्सपीरियंस विद अस।
नमस्कार, राम टेके जी का आज बहुत बड़ा दिन है, जिन्होंने ऑलमोस्ट राम टेके जी हैज बीन डूइंग पेंटिंग and printmaking since the last 55 years. He has used various new technique in printmaking as well as in painting. And he has widened his creative vision. His works are the basic and simple abstract form. Powerful drawings, richness of colors, originality, honesty, and passion of concept and perception. Very much individualistic. When art is expressed, it comes out intuitively. It is spontaneous expression of an inner impulse. That impulse is absolutely free from thought and mind. Art is not merely a skill or a talent to be acquired through technique and practice, but it is an expression of the inner beings, which is to be discovered in the state of total attention and silence. Silence of total energy is the womb of creativity. This energy of life itself will be the focal point of art. Art and life will be one. Thank you.
Sharing his deep bond and association with the artist Sri Ram Teke Ji.
My dear, ladies and gentlemen, my friends, my colleagues, and I should thanks to Karnai and his committee who selected Pramod Babu Ramteke for his retrospective. This work is very important, how to search a talent, untold talent, untold seen, unseen works, which is now visible. Last 2.5 months, Prabhakar, Somesh, and my other friends and sir, we are continuously discussing about this show. How should we mount it? Prabhakar has a spondylosis, but he works 24 hours. We talk 12 o'clock at night. And my association with the Ramteke sir is very close. I am from the Nagpur, he is also from Nagpur. My distant sasur was a teacher of Ramteke sir, Keval Das Bansur. He was an animation filmmaker. I have great respect to the who are sitting the dais. It's not good to take all the time names, but I have great respect, madam. I heard you first time and you give it the history of this place and the scenario of the art. There is a great master. His name was the Thuynh Chuy. He was a Vietnamese 12th century Zen master, says, when we understand how our mind works, our practice become easy. Great Zen master. It is true. When his name came, he said open mind. And that was right, actually. So Prabhakar, he's nicely quoted. Ramteke says, work is the manifestation of Buddhist conversion at Nagpur in 1956, which Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, he embraced Buddhism. And his family was a part and the partial of that conversion. How the new man came. Centuries of the Dalits, centuries of the untouchables, they got that humanity and the force through that conversion. That is the real force. You can see in the literature, you can see in the art, you can see in the sport, you can see in the each and the everything who are the centuries who were the sufferer. His life, when he should write about his life, because I know his life, how he has struggled, how he's went, every time there is some problems. But his family has a background of music, background of military, and he himself is a taekwondo player, he's a black belt of the taekwondo. How this art and taekwondo can go? They are not separate from each other. Every art is part of the other art. There is a concept, it's called as Prachutta Samuttapa. That is the interbeing. Nothing is separate from the one thing from the another. Water is not separate from the fire. Fire is not separate from the air. Fire is not separate from the earth. They are always together. You cannot separate it. How can we view should separate the society? This is great darshana given by the Tathagata Buddha. I always talk to him. He always says, Sami, we should be very cordial with the people. Just like Babasaheb writes in his Buddhanist Dhamma, he said, Buddha was a Saundarya Priya Buddha. Love for the loveliness. And he said in there, Buddha said to Ananda, Anand, you want to attain a nirvana, you should acquaintance with the beauty. You have to close to the beauty. How is the great thought, how is the great aesthetics coming out? I go to the NGMA. We sit, Garnayak, and we discuss about this. And I come back. We have the association, one to one. And slowly we become good friends. That is the acquaintance with the aesthetics is very, very, very important for to understand a person's mind and to attach with them, to close to them. This philosophy, this is not a philosophy, this is the philology. This is the darshana which is given by Tathagata Buddha. Ramtekeshwar's works, when it comes on the minimalism, in the beginning we know at Nagpur he was a portrait painter, but he developed. He has a background of the Navy. And he used to say, Sami jab main Navy mein, main kisi port mein khada rehta tha, mujhe wo lehre aisi lagti thi, ki I am going to close to the Tao. When Bodhidharma took Buddhism to the China, he haven't given to the Buddhism then. He synthesized with the Tao, and Tao is a symbol of water. That's a symbol of water, and Taoism and Buddhism came together is a become a chant. India produces a seed, that is the Dhyana. But the China has a very fertile soil, it's become a chant. It's become a big tree. But China cannot produce a flower. That chant went to the Japan and it's become a Zen. Zen is a flower which we see. When I have seen his minimal work, I said, sir, you are working like a Zen master. You are the Zen. He said, Savi, mere life mein bahut dukh hai. We had one camp in Nagapattinam and we shared the room. Whole night he's talked about his life. You are his brother, you know that. You can be the witness of his pain. I know his sister. I know his son. I know his family. He was always with the battle. But he's such a brave man. And I salute him. He produces such a creative verse because of Prachutta Samuddhava. Interbeing. His core heart is that. He was talking, but he don't know what is called that. मैं बोला सर आप जो बात करते हो आप प्रचित्त समुद्धि बात की बात करते हो और आपके काम में वो गहरी बात है और वो गहरेपन को आपने समझा है. बोलता है यार सभी मुझे नहीं मालूम. मैं उनके मैं आई एम हिज स्टूडेंट बेसिकली नॉट ए डायरेक्ट स्टूडेंट. But his house was an open house for us. You can go 12 o'clock at night. He will welcome you. You go to the any rainy time and the any season, he will welcome you. His house, his studio was the open house. Very few people they came, keep their houses open because mera technique kisi ko pata na chale. Mere se koi mera technique chura ke nahi. Ye dar nahi hai sir mein. Wo to aur aapko batate hain. और आपके साथ इंटरेक्शन करते हैं. इन्होंने बहुत सारी चीजों को जोड़ा है. धम्म का मतलब ही होता है व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द धम्म टू कम टुगेदर. यू वॉटर कैन नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम द एयर. फायर इज नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम द वॉटर विच आई टोल्ड जस्ट लाइक ए इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. You see the preamble, beautiful preamble written by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. Justice, equality, fraternity. The four elements. How is it? They cannot separate. You separate, the constitution will be the no use of that. Babasaheb used that darshan. Our constitution. And that constitution helps to the sir. वो बोलते कि सभी ये बात एकदम ठीक है, मैं भी इसी ढंग से सोचता हूं. देर इज अ टू मच फ्रीडम, देर इज नो जस्टिस. देर इज अ जस्टिस बट देर इज नो फ्रैटर्निटी, देर इज नो यूज. दैट इज द इंटरडिपेंडेंट को-एग्जिस्टेंस, दैट इज अ को-प्रोडक्शन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द प्रचित्त समुत्तम, दैट इज अ कॉन्शियसनेस. Every heart, every human being, everything has a consciousness. And that consciousness developed by Pramod Babu Ramteke in his work. His work is very deep. His work is coming from that manifestation of consciousness of conversion. He always talked about that. And my dear friend, I will tell you, this is a big turning point for the Indian art. We are in the paradigm shift now. This show will reach to the international level. Prabhakar told me he can take this show to the international level. Somesh and the Prabhakar told me that. I will conjure it. They are working like your pillars. And at night, again I will request you, you will give the justice to this show. Many people, they didn't understand this show. I know that there is a problems. But we should resolve that problem with kindness, with open mind, with the direct perception. Direct perception. We listen many things and we react like a reactive mind, but we don't use a creative mind because of there is not a direct perception. What I have seen, what I experienced, that should be my education. I should not listen to anyone. I should understand that thing and we should support that. This attitude needs us now. There should be no personal jealousy. This work is for the nation, not for the individual man. Ramteke is not a person. Ramteke is one of the institute of this country of the aesthetics. I'm speaking very boldly. We need a committee like you. You selected Ramteke. He's sitting in the Nagpur and you selected his work. I don't know who are the selectors, but I know the one of the Vilas and some people. Vilas is a very sensitive person. He can understand what is the depth, how is the palpitate the art. Art is not depend on the how your work sell in the which crores and the lakhs. Art is palpitate. Artists interact with you. Artists communicate with you. For the develop your wisdom. To reach to the nirvana. Therefore, Baba Sahib said in his Buddha's Dhamma, acquaintance with the beauty. And he gave it to the name to the Buddha, Saundarya Priya Buddha. What is a beautiful name? There is a Prajupta Samuttapath is there. We need to revise the Ramteke's works on the academic domain. This study should be teach in colleges, even schools, even door to door. His work is not a minimalistic, his work is the post-minimalistic. Like a Zen master. The Zen masters were the instrument for the to bring the minimalistic. Therefore, this work should reach in the larger audience, reach to the larger hearts and mind, then this show will be quite successful. And I hope so, you will select such kind of shows, very innovative shows. You should search from the bottom, not on the top. Our perspective from the below, always perspective from the above. No, perspective from the below also. Foundation is important. The background is important. This, where they grow, that is very important. To my dear friend, again, I should thanks to the NGMA. Clap to your selection committee. My dear friend Gardnaik, ज़्यादा बोलना उनके बारे में ठीक नहीं है. वो बोलेंगे यार सभी मुझे मक्खन लगा रहे हैं. ऐसा नहीं है. But Gardnaik, he's a really good DC. He himself is a sculptor. He himself is an artist. The way he see the stone, I ever seen the such kind of person who seen the stone. There is a female stone, there is a male stone. Is it true, Vedak? He's a man of stone. But he's a man of kind heart. I'm not speaking because of his, my very close friend. No. But I hope your NGMA should come with the open mind like this show. Conservative mind is not working. Our country will not go up. We want to grow. We have to keep the open mind with the direct perception, with the interbeing, with the prajutta samuttabhat. And today is the time of quantum physics. We are in the science world, quantum. There is David Bohm says, great physicist, he says, whatever is there, one quantum has, one spark of dust has, that quality universal has. That is a Stein's theory showing that. I don't know who was a physics student, they can bring. And this theory came from the Autik Mahasutta of Buddhism, which is given by the Buddha. And the Nagarjuna, Prajitya Samuttabhat is given by Nagarjuna, came through the Buddha study, and that will be the great backbone of international art scenario. Lot of people, Paul Klee, he was a violinist, and he knew that time what is the Stein theory with the violin, and he created Thinking Eyes, that is a Bible of art. People are following that. The science and art, they are not separate from each other. They are not separate. They are one. But we need to aware about, we need to conscious that. Again, I will thank to Director Ma'am, Shariv Doshi Ji, Gardnaik, Ramteke Sir, my dear friend Vilas Shinde, and your committee. And again, I will come. Thanks to Prabhakar. Prabhakar, you have done the great job. You are the person which has seen with the wisdom and your silence. I salute you. I know the inside stories, but I don't want to reveal that. The silence. Again, congratulate to the NGMA. Again, congratulate to the for the humanity, and again, congratulate for the wonderful show, which is the speechless. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite Sri Sankar sir for a word of thanks.
Prabhakar.
There are some flowers, sir.
सर इधर
गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स लिसनिंग टू माय ब्रिलियंट लेक्चर बाय प्रोफेसर सवि सवाकर जी अबाउट द नेचर इट इंटर डिसिप्लिनरी एंड इट इज वेरी मच द एवरीबडीज हार्ट एंड माइंड We all have to get along with rather whatever the philosophy you have, but nature is ultimate. Today is a very special day for Pramod Babu Ramdeke, whom I knew in last 30 years and who was working and many occasions we interacted also. His artworks are, generally people say you cannot walk in dual, double, something like that. But he had exclusively managed his abstract artist. Definitely, but one cannot forget his super realism. He is one of the finest portrait painter in this country, and I personally noticed when he was went to Rashtrapati Bhavan, and he had took the chance of former president of India K.R. Narayanan as a model and a painter for a couple of days, and which was turned to be a fantastic portrait. Not only that, the example. But many more portraits, and he does all the demos wherever he gets the chance in front of any amount of gathering, and that is a very exclusive power hardly you can notice with any artist. As Savi has mentioned, they close the doors, they take the Xerox, imprints, apply colors, and hiding make money. But his art, I don't understand how much money he makes, but his journey is fantastic. Look at his abstract forms. They are all metaphorical. If you see those all the forms, you will indirectly you will understand some human forms, some nature, some clouds, some trees, rocks, stones, etc. But definitely there is something in it which you have to understand the work going through the roots, going to his stages of life. Now I take this. Thank you for this today's very special program. Dr. Sari Doshi ji madam is a well-known person in this country, probably in a particular subject is concerned, excellent authority on it, so she understands very well. I am really grateful and thankful for her to come to this today's occasion, take the opportunity. And she is a proper Jain philosopher, Jain practicing madam. And today's example of this exhibition is Pramod Babu Ramdeke is a Buddhist. Buddhist paintings, Buddhist philosophy, and Jain, Buddhist, and we are all considered to be Hindus and many more other religions, and this is proper India, and we are all together and we are celebrating a wonderful evening today. And Director General Mr. Gadnaya came down all the way from Delhi and making this exhibition is presentable, wonderful evening. On behalf of Government of India, Ministry of Culture, I'm really grateful for giving this opportunity. Likewise, many more opportunities should be given for every one of the society people who are working in a different aspects of their expressions, and especially who has carried out for decades together, and that they deserve the best. And you all have to have a good idea, eye, and trace out, give them wherever they are working, but their work should be recognized. And I also take this thank you or congratulate specially for Ramdeke sir for this giving this beautiful exhibition for us. At that senior age, he has located all his old works and giving for us. It is definitely our most important thing to go around and see this exhibition very properly. I congratulate him. I thank you, Vilas Sindeji and Savi Savarkar, Director Rupa Taramji, and Advisory Committee Chairperson and members. and many more well-known persons in this gathering. I hope this will have a wonderful exhibition, is fantastic success, and probably this will have an opportunity to travel around. आपका नहीं पर दिस गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एनजीएम नेता एंड वी डेफिनेटली एक्सेप्ट हिम एज माय डायरेक्टर आल्सो नॉट ओनली अवर डायरेक्टर माय डायरेक्टर आल्सो दैट मेक्स हार्डली डिफरेंस आई थैंक यू कनेक्ट्स ऑफ यूर कमिंग हियर ग्रेसिंग दिस ओकेजन इट्स अ गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर अस टू थैंक यू लाइकवाइज मेनी मोर ग्रेट स्कॉलर्स एंड ग्रेट इंटेलेक्चुअल पीपल आर देयर इन द गैदरिंग आई थैंक यू ईच एंड एवरी वन फॉर मेकिंग दिस एग्जीबिशन इज सक्सेसफुल आई होप यू विल गो अराउंड द एग्जीबिशन and enjoy the visual treat, understand the philosophy, supports us for making this wonderful. I thank you for all the press, whoever are there for supporting us. Last but not the least, the people who have worked from NGMA, outside, Mr. Zomeji, Ms. Prabhakar, Kamle, that's I thank you everyone for making this vision. Thank you very much.
Gratitude to all the present guests and invitees for their presence. Now exhibition is formally open for the audience. The exhibition will be open for public from 21st September 2021 till 28th of November 2021. The programs ends here and you are requested to join us for the refreshment on the ground floor cafeteria. Dhanyavad, Subharatri.
Thank you.